I'm happy.
Yeah?
You don't have to kiss me because you feel sorry for me.
I'm kissing you because I want to.
He's delicious. Too delicious. College starts very soon. Do you really want to be the only girl to turn up with your V-plates intact?
Is everything okay?
I've just got a massive headache. A fresh meat, babe. It's like they're all sitting at our restaurant waiting for the delivery and we're the food. I'm a mess.
Different week. Same old bullshit.
Come on, it's 9:10.
All right.
I'll be late, but bloody hell.
How'd your first week go?
All right. English isn't bad. The teacher's called Mr. Hodgson. He swears a little bit, you know, to try and make himself look cool. Performing arts is fine. We play this game where you have to say, she stood upon the balcony, inimitably mimicking him hiccuping and amicably welcoming him in. You have to say it as fast as you can. I have to sit next to this kid called Andrew Johnston, who smells intensely of garlic. You know, he told me that he has a garlic baguette for supper every night.
Do I look different?
What do you mean?
Am I sweating? Can I tell you I'm going for the change?
You had mentioned it, yeah.
Bloody love this song.
Oh, come on. Mum, you can't cry to the Spice Girls. It's not exactly girl power, is it?
Hey, do you reckon they'd let me and you join?
Oh, yeah. Who would I be? Underactive thyroid spice?
I could be menopause spice. tell you what I really, really want.
Oh, tell me what you really, really want.
No, I'll tell you what...
If you want to be my lover...
Sometimes, when you're telling a lie, the more detail you go into, the more even you start to believe that it might be true. The bit about the swearing English teacher? He's based on my Uncle Mark, who thinks dropping the F word into every sentence makes him seem cool. The bit about the performing arts game? Well, it was a tongue twister I got last Christmas in a cracker. And the bit about the kid who eats garlic bread all the time? That's autobiographical. The truth is that I've not been to college since I set the alarm off. Missed the whole first week. The truth is, I'm becoming so good at talking bollocks that I'm thinking of going professional.
What about bullshit, Spice?
How did you figure out I wasn't going?
When a parent asks a child how school was and they give more than a one-word answer. Suspicious. And just the way you were. My instincts told me something wasn't quite right. Plus they rang me, told me I'd been coming in.
I told you last week I was having a cigarette.
Where?
I didn't set the alarm off.
You were seen by the fire door.
What can I tell you?
I know it was you who did it, and when I get proof...
Why would I set the alarm off?
And when I get proof, you're in for it. I'm not messing about this term. Liam, honestly. Mrs. Earl.
Time to face the music.
So, Ray, what's going on? Why have you been skipping classes? Did something happen?
No, nothing happened.
Do you remember those conversations we had when you were thinking about applying? You said you thought you were ready for the stresses of college life.
When someone asks you a question, you give a response. Got a conversation, Ray.
Yeah, I remember.
Well, maybe this is a sign that you're not ready. There's an argument to be made for deferring a year.
No, please, please don't make me do that. I don't want
that. That way you can come back when you're a bit stronger.
No, please, that's not what I want.
Well, why don't you tell me what you do want?
I want to be treated the same as everyone else.
Okay, then I'm giving you a formal warning. If you break the rules again, if you misbehave, skip classes, then we are going to have to talk seriously about you deferring. Understood?
Yes. And she's sorry, aren't you, Ray?
Yeah.
As Uncle Mark might say, am I fucking sorry? Fuck the fuck off!
Here she is. Where the fuck have you been? I've been worried about you. Thought I was supposed to be your stereotype gay best friend.
Sorry, Chuck. Why do you come here, Archie?
I need the grades to get into Durham. Why do you want to come in?
I don't know. Wait, are you wearing a rugby top?
Yeah.
When did you start smoking? Archie, what is going on with you?
Come on, take a walk with me. Surviving college is all about blending into the background. If anyone knows anything about staying under the radar, it's Uncle Archie.
You know it's really creepy when you say that, don't you?
Noted. Well, Arch, easy macker.
But I like it. Yeah. Have you seen what Maggie Tolson's wearing today?
Well, you could choke a dozen camels on those whamps.
I wish I was a dozen camels.
Nice one, yeah?
Nice one, mate. Look at me. There's only one rule, understand?
Yeah.
Stay under the radar. Oh, what have you come as?
On the first day, do you remember that dress I was wearing? And I saw that other girl wearing it. Well, the other day, I saw two girls in the same dress and one with nearly the exact same shoes on. I am not taking chances anymore. I hate this place. It's like I'm invisible. Oh, my God, there's Stacey Stringfellow's gang.
Who's Stacey Stringfellow?
Ray, if you're in with them, then you're in.
In where?
With the boys.
Which boys?
The fit boys.
I've got a boyfriend.
Yeah, well, I haven't. Hi, Stacey! Oh my God, she just completely blanked me. I can't even process this.
She's been looking for you.
College wasn't the only thing I'd been avoiding. Because of what happened at the caravan, I'd stayed away from him. I didn't want to be the girl who couldn't get undressed in front of a boyfriend. I really missed him, and smelling his jacket was no substitute whatsoever.
Finn rang again.
What did you say?
Well, I didn't know what to say, so I told him you might have glandular fever.
What?
Well, last time, when I said you'd gone to France, you got a right cob on.
That is the most stupid thing.
Yeah, well, maybe we're not all as good at lying as you are, Ray. Just stop avoiding him.
I'm not avoiding him.
You've got through your first full day at college, Ray, and I'm proud of you.
You're not going to cry, are you?
You can't spend your life running away from stuff. There's a history of that in this family.
My mum was right about once every 3 years, but I had a feeling that this was one of those times.
I was starting to think you'd left the country.
Or at least Lincolnshire.
Thought about it.
Not that I've missed you or anything.
No.
Okay, I might have thought about you once. All right, twice. I was going to come round, actually, but your mum said something about...
Listen, I was just a bit... out of it. And I didn't want to tell you, because I didn't want to drag you into it.
No, I don't mind that you've got stuff. Everyone's got stuff, really, but...
All right, lovebird. Where have you been, Raimundo? I've been ready to send out a sexy search party for you.
Yes, shot. Foster's mate, nice one.
But... I'd forgotten. I'd forgotten that there's something in his lips. And no matter how crap my life was, no matter how much I didn't fit in at college, no matter what, when I had his lips, I had his kiss. And so long as I had that, I knew everything would be okay.
My dad's at a conference all week, right? So I was thinking about having an exclusive sleepover tomorrow night.
How exclusive?
Well, I was only going to invite one person. Fancy it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Day two of college. If I could get through the day, I had Finn waiting for me that night. But staying under the radar isn't easy when you're 6 foot tall and weigh 16 stone. I had to be... bland.
This isn't Paul. Is Civic. He's got this almost magical ability to invent a nickname for someone and have it stick for the rest of that person's life. This kid here, he was in Simi's high school. In swimming class, he got an unfortunate crease in his trunks. Simi called him Aquabone, and it stuck. That was 5 years ago. Even his dad calls him it. This girl here, Simi decided she had a big chin. She lost her shoe at the end of your disco. Cinderella.
That's actually quite clever.
He's an evil genius. So, trust me, do not do anything extraordinary around him.
Don't look. Why are you looking? Oh, bollocks, here he comes. Look away. Look away. Look away!
Easy, Arch. Oh. All right, Simi. Hey, you seen Graham Tippin's new glasses, mate? Looks like Elton John.
I doubt Elton John sleeps on plastic sheets in case he pisses the bed, though, mate. Look who it is. You're at Unicorn Balls. Unicorn Balls, where are you going, man?
So I thought I'd take this time to talk about the power of positive thinking. It's about seeing the good side of things. It's about filling your life with things that make you happy.
Sorry.
Pull up a chair, Liam. Just about to ask the group if they could think of things that make them happy.
Oh, I'll go first.
Okay.
Every day I go to a sixth form college.
And shite.
It's like being a social experiment, where they keep a load of people in the same building, and the only thing they all have in common is their age. And because of this, it's populated by people trying to fit in. The teachers push an ideal on us. Succeed here or be a failure in life. Learn this 15th century lyric poem and hypothesize on its significance to the French Revolution. Or be worthless in society. I feel hatred towards the whole thing. And when I feel that hatred, I feel happy. Because I realize that that's not me. They're not me, and they never will be. It makes me fucking delirious!
I like it on Wednesdays, when that canteen serves the dessert with jelly and custard, you know.
Oh, yes.
That trifle thing.
Oh, yeah. Hiya.
All right.
I liked your speech. I hate college as well. I just wanted to say, about the other day when I set the alarm off, it was an accident.
I didn't say anything.
Well, you're not going to say anything, are you? It's just, I'm on a warning at college.
I didn't see anything.
That's Finn Nelson.
Yeah?
He is the fittest lad in college. I'd honestly let him do anything to me.
You'd let anyone do anything to you?
Fuck off. The best part is that he's single.
He's not single. What? Who's he going out with?
Some lucky bitch.
Doesn't matter anyway.
He wouldn't even talk to girls like us. This is impossible. How am I supposed to stay under the radar when everyone at college knows who Finn is? He's the fittest lad in college, and I'm...
Chloe, how weird is it that I'm going out with Finn?
Do you know?
No. Be honest.
Right, okay. Out of 10, how attractive would you say you were?
1.
Don't be stupid. You're easily 4.
Thanks.
No, I mean like a 4 at worst. You know, when you're hungover and you're on and stuff.
Right.
Fine. Rate Finn out of 10.
11.
Exactly. That isn't even possible. Even Emma Coghill's sister fancies him and she's like 23. I've just been out with footballers.
So why does he like me?
I don't know. Maybe you're his type or something.
What type would that be?
Curvaceous.
Stop it.
And let's be honest, if he likes big boobs and he struck gold,
they are cripplingly large.
Anyway, stopping it is tonight, so it's probably gonna happen. Thought we were having a campaign. Oh, no, we didn't. Because...
Did he drink too much?
Yeah. Do you know why I hate that?
Yeah.
Listen, your first time is always gonna be the scariest. Just make sure he doesn't drink it too much and you'll be fine.
But right, for the past 4 weeks all we've talked about is sex, right?
Noises, positions, worst and best case scenarios, handjob techniques, blowjob techniques, how sensitive men's nipples are, foreskins, porn, anal, even strap-ons. There's nothing else to talk about, right? Just let him whack it in you. Right?
Doing a photo shoot.
And then we talked for like 90 hours. And then you agreed it was a bad idea.
Why do underwear shots?
Well, I wanted to build up my modeling portfolio. Oh my god, Ray, everybody's staring at me.
Right. Where are the originals and the negatives?
Well, I don't know. No, I took him to Lisa Golden's party. I haven't seen him since.
Did you show anyone at the party?
I got really drunk and I showed some to Barney. No, but there was over 50 people there and I didn't know half of them. It could be anyone. Ray, we really need to find out who's got the photos before they print off any of the other ones.
What other ones? My God, Chloe. Why would you do that? I wanted to keep the glamour door open.
Glamour door?
You're 16. There is no door. Well, if you never not wanted to have pictures taken, well, you look amazing. Right, with your hair's done and your makeup and the lighting and you look sexy. Right, you feel sexy. No?
You mess with her, you mess with me. Poor Chloe. College is utterly barbaric. At least I'd made it through the day under the radar, and now I had Finn all to myself. I was starting to think that me and him only made sense when no one else was around. I still didn't know why he liked me, but maybe Chloe had it spot on. Maybe I was his type. Now all I needed was a bit of courage. Courage in any form.
You want it tonight, girl?
No, I just fancied a drink. Want some?
No, fine.
Cheers, my dear.
Cheers.
You can do this. The first time is the scariest. Man up.
Where's this one?
That is Butlins and Skegness. I think I was five.
Is that your mum?
That's her, yeah.
She's pretty.
Yeah.
Do you miss her?
Yeah.
Who's this?
Oh, God. That's Stacey Stringfellow. She goes to college.
Right, so why have you got this?
We used to go out. I told you, it's been ages since I looked at these. I'll throw that one out.
No, it's no big deal. Everyone's got exes. Have a drink.
No, I'm fine, seriously.
Just relax. Just relax, just relax. He wants this. You want this.
Right, I'm pouring you one.
Oh, really? Cheers, my dear. Mm. No more. Cheers, me dear.
Yeah, cheers, me dear. Just
what I found. I'm gonna, I think I'm gonna have to go to the bathroom.
Come back. had a freak out. I accidentally set an alarm off. You're not going to tell anyone, are you? They'll kick me out, Kester, promise me.
Of course I won't.
What were you doing at the time? Tell me about that.
I was just walking down the corridor.
Alone?
Yeah. No. I was with Finn.
Your boyfriend?
Yeah. I don't get why he likes me. I'm not even his type. His ex was so tiny and beautiful. It's embarrassing to be next to him. I'm embarrassed for him.
So do you think you can't believe he likes you because you can't find anything to like about yourself? That's what we're trying to fix.
Well, that takes ages. I need a short-term solution.
This is therapy. There are no short-term solutions.
Fine. Short-term, you've got three options.
One, you start facing those things you're afraid of. Stop caring about what other people think. Start to like yourself. Option two, you can leave college.
Nope, I can't do that. What's option three?
Leave Finn.
I guess I'll just try option one then.
Yeah.
Yeah. As always, Kester was annoyingly right. The only real option was to face my fears. I had to be around Finn in college, not just to help my anxieties, but also because a circle of vultures were gathering over his head. Just kiss him. Okay. Just kiss him. Okay. Are you ready? Yeah. There's a rumor going round about, yeah? What? Are you going out with someone? No.
Told you.
I can't do it. I can't be near him at college. The vultures can circle. I'd rather hide than be eaten alive. I'd still be his girlfriend, just part-time.
Who's got them?
No. Everyone's been really nice about it. I've actually been asked out by a few of the lads.
Seriously?
I know. It's so inappropriate, but... Well, that's lads for you, I guess.
Hey, Claire.
Hey, Stace. Is it a good game?
Brutal.
So I'll see you later still?
Yeah, definitely.
What just happened? Well, the girls have actually been really supportive. Stacey even asked if I wanted to go for a bite to eat after college.
How nice is that?
I don't know, I'm just hoping whoever's got the pictures will stop. It'll all go away anyway, so...
Why would it all go away? You need to find out who it is. Or at least tell a teacher.
Will you just drop it, Ray, because I don't want to talk about it, okay?
Okay.
Good afternoon.
Is it?
Listen, Ray. I need to talk to you about something. Big news, yeah? I'm going through the change.
Oh, God.
And I'm thinking of getting some work done.
What work?
Cosmetic surgery.
Are you actually insane? How can we even afford that? You know, last week, you said that I could only throw a tea bag away after it had made 3 cups of tea. So all week, I've been trying to save you money by drinking tea that looks and tastes like ass piss. And now you want to go and throw away thousands of pounds getting your baps remoulded or your bingo wings clipped. No bloody way, Mum. Don't cry. You were doing so well. You don't even have bingo wings.
I do. I just want Kareem to be attracted to me. I've punched well above my weight with him, Ray. It's not just that he's handsome either, or that he's got this firm little body on him, but he is sensational in bed. He attends to my every need, and I feel like I'm being taken by a man possessed.
Yeah, I get it. He's hot. You like him.
When we're at the club, I feel people must look at us and think, how the bloody hell did that happen? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Do you want a brew?
Ray. Use one tea bag per cup.
So, maybe I wasn't ready to be around Finn in college, but I had to see him outside. Or what was the point? And that meant taking my clothes off. But the truth was that I was astounded by people who could be naked. Not just in front of others, but in front of themselves. If I couldn't do that, how could I ever do it in front of someone else? The problem is that being naked leaves you nowhere to hide. I just don't get it. Go.
What? Stop! Look! What are you doing?
Can we not do this here, Finn?
Do what? Why are you being a dickhead?
Don't call me a dickhead.
You've been ignoring me, deny it. What? Is it because of the other night? I know I got a bit drunk, but you were giving me drink all the time. Sorry.
It's not that.
Then what is it?
I just don't get it.
You don't get what?
You're an 11 and I'm a 4.
I've got no idea what you're talking about.
You should be going out with people like Stacey, not someone like me. Most people, when they see us, must be thinking, oh, he must be mad going out with that.
That what? That what? You don't tell me who I can and can't fancy, all right? That is mine. That belongs to me. No one else, no one, not even you.
So why do you like me?
Because I do, that's it.
But why?
Just because. Now you're gonna stop being a dickhead.
Stop calling me a dickhead. You're the dickhead.
You're the dickhead.
You're a dickhead.
Yeah.
Come on. Oh, shit.
Oh, no.
Shit, he's jumped.
Oh, my God. No. No, don't do that. Then they'll find out that we were in here together. They'll think we've been fucking.
Why would we fuck in a disabled toilet?
Because there's more room in here than in a normal toilet. It's even got these little handle things. For purchase.
Right, well, what do you suggest?
Okay. Have you got one of those mobile telephones?
No, of course I'm not. I'm not a millionaire. We're just going to have to get help from somebody. Hello?
No, this cannot be happening.
Hello? Hiya, mate. Can you get some help for us? We're stuck in here.
Are they still in there?
This is not happening.
Mate, can you just go and get someone, please?
Down. I've got big news.
You're going through the change. I get it. But you need to accept it and then just move on.
No, I'm not going through the change. All my emotional ups and downs.
We're pregnant!
What?
We're pregnant!
I am pregnant!
What?
5 sodding months pregnant!
5 months?
I feel better than I've ever felt. And I thought I was past it. I'm in my prime, aren't I, baby? Oh, say something.
It's brilliant. Congratulations.
I'm going to cry. Can I cry?
Yeah, I think you're allowed to cry.
Gentlemen, this may be the finest day of our lives. It may also be the last.
I didn't even want to think about facing college the next day.
Some say that bravery is merely foolishness by a different name. Gentlemen, we're about to find out which is true. It's been an honor serving with every single one of you. Captain, the pleasure is ours. Chin chin, gentlemen.
Chin chin. Chin chin. Chin chin.
Maybe I just had to be brave. Face my fears. Like Kester pointed out, it wasn't like I had any other options.
Apparently, they looked like they were fucking. Kirsty Fairclough said you could smell it on them when they came out.
In the disabled toilet, Finn Nelson.
And this girl called Rayel.
And they're just going for it. Bollock naked!
Oh, not honestly, mate. Well, who was the girl then?
Rayel. Fat girl.
First year.
What?
Magic funny.
All right, Paul Daniel.
What?
Where's Devin McGee?
Why Paul Daniels?
Allow me to explain. Finn went out with Stacey Stringfellow, for fuck's sake. There's only one possible explanation. Ray Earl has a magic fanny.
What? What's a magic fanny?
It's when you see good-looking lads with proper minging girls. They've got magic fannies. A Ray Earl has, like, the fucking Paul Daniels of magic fannies, mate. I
Wait.
hands on something flat. Put your hands on something flat. You all right, babe? All right? And what happened? Are they kicking you out?
I just can't handle it.
In college? Right, you mean college, right?
Is everyone talking about it?
Well, they'll get over it. Are you seeing Finn tonight? That's exciting.
I was thinking about the photos. I think we should tell Mrs. Dixon and then go to the police.
No, I don't think we should do that.
Some evil fucker has got it in for you.
No, Ray.
We go to the police, and even if they don't find out who, it'll scare whoever off.
No, Ray!
Why aren't you doing something about this?
If you don't do it, I'm gonna...
No, you can't!
Why? Why not?
Because it was me! What do you mean?
Why put the pictures out there?
I don't understand. Why would you do that?
It's not a bad thing to want to be popular.
That's crazy.
Yeah, but it worked, didn't it? Right, don't be mad at me.
I'm not mad.
Dear Diary, it's easy to be brave, and it's easy to be confident. If you look good, if you feel sexy, and if you fit in. But that's not the world I live in. And it's not just that people stare and call me names, that I can't fit in when we're together. It's that I'd rather break up with the man of my dreams than take my clothes off in front of him, than let him touch me, than let him soak me up like I do him. So Kester might think I'm running away, but he gave me the options. And, in a way, I am facing my fears. I am doing the thing I'm most afraid of. And that, dear diary, is how I messed everything up. I suppose I sorted one thing out, though. I knew where I felt most normal. I knew where I found it easiest to fit in.
I've been waiting for you to visit. Can we talk for a bit? You don't have to.
I'd like that.
All right, alarm girl.
All right, therapy, Liam.
You look like you could do with a drink.
Cheers, my dear.
Head over to e4.com/mymadfatdiary for extra special stuff from the show, video extras, Spotify playlists, and a 360-degree view of Ray's room. And support for the issues raised can be found at channel4.com/support. And tomorrow on E4, get ready to be bowled over by tats, tricks, cards, and magic. Troy is one smooth fella here at 10.